I have 7 o'clock, so I'm going to call the meeting to order. And we will begin with the approval of the agenda. Does anyone have any roundtable items? So I'm going to recommend we strike that from the agenda today. So may I have a motion to...
Motion to move that amendment.
Second.
To approve as amended.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? So moved. And may I have approval of the minutes of the 4:29 special meeting and the 5:19 special meeting?
Motion to approve.
Second. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? So moved. And do we have any public comment?
Is this an appropriate time to bring something that was brought to me as a suggestion from the councilperson to be brought to the ABC committee?
Does it have to do with anything on the...
It doesn't have to do with anything on the agenda. So would I just suggest them to write a letter?
So you can like read a letter or something, a communication. We don't go back and forth and respond.
Right, there would be no... So the suggestion was simply because we have in our town gone back and forth about having high school tuition free to the high school staff, and probably will be looking at that again. But it was suggested that that might be something that the region, that all the schools would want to offer together because it's a regional high school. That's an interesting idea.
So I think that should probably go to the Region 1 board.
Is that how that, oh, okay.
Okay.
So that would be, okay.
All right. Any other public comment? Hearing none, we will move on to regionalization, and Patricia is going to summarize the work, the research that's occurred.
We just emailed to you, and you would not have had time, nor could you possibly skim it because of the sizes of the document, but we emailed to you some research we gathered on enrollment, where districts have looked at enrollment or looked at their district structure or taken a strategic look at declining enrollment. And Region 12 did just that. They created a strategic plan. It speaks very specifically to declining enrollments with a recommendation. It talks about internal and external groups, which makes me think they did some focus group type studies, and this study was done by Education Connection. So I can pass it around. We can make hard copies if you need us to, but we thought you would have time.
It's been emailed to you.
We wouldn't have time to really delve into them tonight, but I wanted you to know that I took a peek at them. The next is Regional District 4. 4 is Deep River, Essex, and that is this, Chester, Deep River, and Essex. It's 3 towns, 1 community. It's a pre-K-12 program, and they did the same thing. They took a good look at what their issues were as a board and talked more globally than 12 did. They were very specific. But they talked in here about preserving neighborhood schools. They talked about what regionalization is and isn't. Because in our district, you remember our structure so unique, what would be regionalization in one school district that's a K-12 school district could be quite different than regionalization in Region 1. So they did an analysis of that.
And we got that one too?
And you have this one too. So you have the whole packet. Okay. They use that preliminary work to say, our goal is to better serve students. So it wasn't about saving money or
that's
their goal was about serving students better. So they were probably going to focus on programming. And they talked about a lack of centralized authority for fiscal and administrative issues, because they have similar issues to us. There are 4 boards and a committee like you. They have a committee as well. And they have 33 board members. So they don't have quite as many as we do, but again, and they certainly have less boards. But they have a similar kind of structure regionally, and one that we should take a good look at. It talks about the boards of ed, how many are on, who they are, members, how the district is supervised. Because again, of our situation on shared services, you want to have those conversations. and then their regional structures. Less in this document that I can see at a glance about enrollment, more about programming and structures. So there's a little draft document. This, I believe, is the product. And the last one we had for you is Norfolk Colebrook Public Schools, and this is a proposed regionalization plan. This was a study done by Education Connection. They paid to have them take a look at their district with an emphasis on that declining enrollment for them was as major of an issue as it is for you. Well worth taking a look at. They talk about establishment of regional districts, how that works, what's the process, what are the legal ramifications. The committee then came up with, or not committee, the team that worked on this, they came up with recommendations. I don't know where the process is at. I don't think they are moving forward right now. Whether they're relooking what they're doing at the moment, I'd have to make a phone call and find out where it's at. But they did come up with some key recommendations. I don't know if they've implemented this plan or are they just in the research phase.
Do you know, or in any of these, did you see that they, because we had talked about doing a survey?
Right.
Do any of these, to your knowledge, have?
It looks like if the one group looks like they either did a focus group or a survey.
Okay.
To gather data, then I think that was 12.
Because it'd be interesting if we could talk to them about
their survey,
their process, the survey,
right.
The questions they asked. The,
right.
So maybe we can go a little deeper, and that'll give us a chance to sort of look this over for the next meeting. And if there's any way you could find out what their,
right.
Did they survey?
Did they
do
could
focus
we have
groups?
Copies of their surveys?
Yeah.
So. And generally, if they do a survey, if it's not in the back of the document under the appendix, they did some sort of preliminary one that they were just setting, like, what's our purpose? What's our goal? Which we could do as well. So I will ask all those regions.
So then perhaps for the next meeting, we'll download these.
Spend a little time on it. And okay. See if there's anything in it that appeals to you. Is there a collection of data that appeals to you? Is there a purpose? Maybe there's a purpose that you like the way they tackled it. You know, before you hire somebody, you would want to know all of those things. Before you would pay somebody to come in and do a task, you want to give them really clear instruction on what you want them to be looking at. And, you know, often these studies can take on a life of their own.
It, would it be worth asking Education Connection, like what
right,
if,
services?
If we were to consider, mm-hmm. you know, working with them, what kind of services do they provide?
Yep.
Just to get a sense mm-hmm. of that.
I can call Dan and yeah.
So of all these, if Connection just did region 12, is that correct?
I think there's
did?
Two. I think they did
yeah.
two of the groups. They did the Colebrook.
Right,
the Norfolk
one.
Two.
Norfolk. I thought they actually went to a referendum or something. I think
they did, but I'm not sure anything came out of that.
Hey, there's a good story on Colebrook and Norfolk in the Waterbury Republican.
Okay.
They just literally went to announce to the towns what they think they ought to do. They haven't gone to vote yet.
All right, so that's, yeah, and again.
They had two public forums, and also they're looking for exemptions from the State Board of Education on certain issues as well. So
Right. They're
moving forward.
So they're making some gains, but it's a process that takes a lot of steps. And it would help to have somebody kind of shepherd us through that once we know what we want. What do we want to achieve?
Any other thoughts that you might want on regionalization? All right. Moving on to the 7,000 series, when we left our special meeting, we left it that we would contact Gary Groshu to see if he felt we could. So, Paul, you weren't here. We decided that we were leaning more towards a rewrite of the 7,000 series. And our question to Gary was, you know, does he think we can achieve our goals through policy?
I spoke with Jonathan. So,
okay.
Yeah.
And he does believe we can. He could not get something together for us for this meeting, but he will work on something. And he said, you know, as we get into it, we'll see what issues arise, but he feels, you know, he has sort of our goals laid out, and he feels we can address them that way. So
your
that's
list
my update.
Of
the
so
list of
before June 17th,
I think so.
I could.
So that's good news.
Yeah.
All right. Anything else on the 7,000 series? Moving right along, the joint employment agreement.
Something an opportunity around while I'm about that.
Well, before you do, okay. I think I want to share. So, Patricia and I spoke with Gary today, and he and Fred Dorsey actually had a conversation yesterday, and they came to the decision that they feel it would be beneficial to this group if they were to meet together, just the two of them, to go paragraph by paragraph through the joint agreement to address any concerns that Fred Dorsey has. Gary felt that that would be a good way to address the concerns rather than have it, rather than have it be a big group, he wanted it to be just himself and Fred Dorsey going through it, with the goal to resolve the issues. So they are scheduling a meeting for Friday afternoon, and then they will get back to us to let us know, did they resolve the issues? You know, Gary can't say until he goes through it with Dorsey what the issues are. I think we're familiar with what the issues are. They are going to have that meeting, and then we'll come back to us. And essentially it'll be, you know, did they resolve the issues in our agreement that this agreement should move forward? And if not, then we may be at a point where the six boards who do want to sign it would sign it, and if one doesn't want to, then they wouldn't. He felt that it was, you know, a good way to just try to work it out. Do you have anything to add to that, Patricia?
No, just that Fred Dorsey was contracted by the town of Canaan, not the Board of Education.
So who's paying for this?
Well, I think we would pay for this one session. If it continues, we would send any further sessions to Kellogg, the bills to Kellogg, if it just can't get resolved. I mean, if this just goes on and on
well,
and
it
on.
Has gone on.
One question.
How much have we already spent on Gary Roshu working on this?
I'm sure we've spent a fair amount of money over the year, a year and a half. We've been working on it a long time.
Mm-hmm.
So I can pull that information for you if I don't have it.
Mm-hmm. I would hope that all that time spent makes the 7,000 series time with Gary Bush less, because it's so many of the same questions that were coming up. In the big picture, I would hope that it makes the time spent on the 7,000 series less because so many of the same issues had to be looked at. So that was a big part of why it was worth it to us as a board to spend that time and money.
You mean like this? Question on what the statutes really are supposed to say.
Can you speak up? I'm having a hard time hearing back here.
Oh, sorry.
Please.
Meaning the discussion of what the statutes really intend and... how our region is set up and how we would go about making changes if we choose to make changes. And to us, that was what we, our understanding as a board is that that's why this was so important to look at. Because it was about all that, not just about this one little document. Excuse me. Was that heard?
Anyone have any comment, other further comments on that? So we should hear back from Gary on Friday afternoon, is my guess. And then we'll, you know, share with everyone what the recommendation is at that point.
And we're assuming that they'll be such small matters that we won't have to go back to our boards.
Right, they could be, you know, is it preferences versus legalities? Is it wordsmithing? You know, what are the issues? So we thought, let's let the two lawyers go through it and come out and hopefully resolve things.
I would be curious to see how much money we've spent on this, though.
I can pull that. We had an FOI request not too long ago, so I think that
you have most of it too.
We have a lot of it. It's just pulling the bills since then to now.
And so June 17th will be the final date? Can we, I mean, every time we get together, this is the day we're going
to
finish.
Can I say something about that? Because I'm trying to understand that myself, very much so. Because I understand that you guys have been working on this a lot, and that there's a sense that July of 2015 is a natural deadline, because that would be the point.
I think we need to wait and let the two lawyers go through it and then see what we resolve, and at that point we would then move forward in whatever direction we move forward in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think we would have to have a special meeting to do any changes in time for July.
Right. So they're meeting on Friday, which is good. They're meeting this week, so we should have a sense, you know, at least by the beginning of next week. Did they find resolution? But I think it's premature to start talking about deadlines when we just need to go through this one last piece. Anything else? All right.
Can I ask? Sorry, because this is just in my Is there any other deadline that I'm not aware of that's come as far as, obviously we all know that this came up because there was concerns about the validity of the contract we had, and nobody wants to have that, nobody wants to leave our superintendent hanging like that. Is there any other deadlines I'm not aware of except for the ones that have been sort of created as a group?
Not that I'm aware of. Okay. I mean, I think
I didn't know if there was sort of the original impetus, like this has to happen by.
No, I think, you know, the we were working towards having this go into effect on July 1st. Mm-hmm. I think that is still our goal.
Right.
But right now, given that we're once again taking a step back, we can't put a deadline on it until we have gone through this process. But I would say that our goal is still to have it go into effect on July 1st. Mm-hmm. You know, that's the goal. Is
that
a deadline?
It's goal.
Very different from a deadline.
Right.
That's the goal.
Okay.
Do you guys agree with that?
Yeah.
I mean, I just feel strongly we need to get it off our plate because we're trying to move on, and, you know.
Well, like I said, I think that the issues are very... I think this is resolving a lot of stuff that would have come up with the 7000 series.
But it's different.
It's a totally different.
It's very different.
I think that's sort of been the issue from get-go. I think it's been globbed onto this agreement, this whole other context, which is not in this agreement at all. You want to talk about the equal abortion, that's one thing. But all this other stuff is sort of this moving target of frankly, stuff that is... the chair of your board has not been able to explain to this board in all the time we were working on. So the Board of Education, Falls Village, never came to this table and made those issues clear, ever. Frankly, to reach one board, to this board, never. It's only been since the hiring of an attorney that that preference of how this works mm-hmm. has come to light. Putting aside the apportionment.
And that hiring is by the town, not,
right.
not the Board of Education.
So, you know, we're a board of group of Board of Education, and for us not to be able to understand from one town what that issue is, to be clear, so we can have a communication that works over a period of a year, is
longer
why I need longer. But for it to come up, and this is where the frustration is, this is coming up again and again at the very end. And yes, it may be appear to be in the effort of making it a better agreement, but you have two attorneys that are phenomenal attorneys. They've both done CAE presentations, they're both excellent attorneys, and attorneys always have different opinions. And, you know, we're sort of caught in a crossfire as boards of education, and that to me is a shame. But I don't think it has anything to do with what we're, the next step of what we do.
And it's unfortunate that we keep incurring costs because of that.
And as I said a long time ago, when the first thing out of the gate was, well, this is a lawsuit, it doesn't set a tone that boards of education can work together easily without this kind of discourse. And it's been very difficult, unfortunately.
And we're lucky we got an assistant superintendent, and I really hope she's not paying attention to this right now, because this is not pretty.
It makes it very hard to hire people.
We need to stick by our administrators if we want to keep hiring wonderful administrators. So.
Oh, I was thinking more about the boards working together, though. I mean,
if
the boards working together, that's the thing that's getting up here is,
I can honestly tell you,
we'd love to share a superintendent.
Putting all this aside, it really does feel that we've not been dealing with the Board of Education. We've been dealing with the town.
Right.
The Board of Education has not shown up here in a way to represent its views correctly all along, and that's what's very hard. And this is not personal, it's just that I've watched your meeting. It's very hard for anyone to chair that meeting and come to this table and explain something, because we've tried. It's hard to understand what the minutia is of what somebody's after.
Mm-hmm.
I get the equal apportionment. That's clear as day. But the rest of it,
and I think that's why I asked about a deadline, because I'm skeptical that even after a meeting on Friday that there's going to be a conclusion.
Well, there may,
and so
there may
are
be.
Are we all just going to keep saying, okay,
but,
well, let's try this?
But I think if when they meet, if they may resolve it, which is great, and we move forward. They may resolve it, and Dorsey may recommend to not the Falls Village Board of Ed. I think it's going to be the selectmen that it's
a
good contract.
Well, that's the thing, is that for us having them meet, I mean, I feel like we've done our due diligence and are trying to do our due diligence as much as we can in the situation we're in. And for them to meet, and your goal of July 1st, we are taking that seriously, that it's sort of like, what else can be done?
So I think to finish, I think that they're going
to
come out of it and say, we resolved it or we didn't.
And then we have
at
to
that point,
make a decision.
You have to make a decision, and we have to make a decision to move forward with it, with six boards, or, you know, so I don't think it's going to keep pushing it out, but it's going to inform which way it moves. Anything else on the joint employment agreement? So stay tuned.
Okay. We'll get an email from you, you think?
Yeah, I don't know if we'll just go into executive, call a special meeting, or
I think you're going to have to wait and see.
See what happens.
And see what happens and ask Gary's advice.
Right.
He'll advise you. And
so you should be hearing something next week.
Yeah.
If not Friday.
I mean, you could say, depending on what happens, we're going to do this. We can do this at our next regularly scheduled meeting. Right? It doesn't give other.
That would be very difficult for boards to have special meetings and.
Well, My board is not going to meet again.
No, we're.
Yeah, we're not meeting until July.
We're.
We have to have a special meeting no matter what. It's just a question of we have a short window of our.
There may not be substantive changes, so it may.
It may not be a meeting where the.
Right.
It may just be this group that meets.
Maybe before the 17th.
It might be this group that has a special meeting, not all of the boards, because Claude, you are right. I mean.
So we'll figure the logistics out.
I start next week.
Based on what comes out of that meeting.
You don't meet in June, so.
All right.
So do you want a motion to go into executive?
Executive session and invite in the superintendent? Would you guys like to do that?
So moved.
For the purpose of?
For the purpose of.
For the purpose of the superintendent evaluation slash contract.
And then I'll excuse myself and may Miss Tina.
Can we just motion to go in the eight of both?
Correct.
Well, thank you, everyone. Have it.